What's up everyone, NK's here. Today, I have something exciting to share with you. This is the first time I and everyone at ThinkView had a chance to try out the 3D display that doesn't require glasses. And honestly, it's amazing. So, this is the Samsung Odyssey 3D, and seeing 3D on this thing, totally mind-blowing. In this video, I will walk you through how this 3D display actually tricks your brains and how it creates a spatial depth feeling like a ball flying out of the screen. And in those games that take place in the forest, you can literally feel the depth of the tree. Yeah, I know, it's that immersive. So, let's break it down. So, to explain how a 3D display works, we have to start with how humans perceive depth. So, we have two eyes, right? And each one spaced about 5 to 7 cm apart. So, each one will see a slightly different image. Now, try this. Hold your finger up in front of you, and then close one eye at a time, and you will see like your finger jumping left to right. So, when you see things with both of your eyes, your brain then merges these two slightly different images into one, creating the perception of depth. And that's the basic principle behind 3D. Now, in order to see a 3D effect on the screen, you first need a 3D compatible content in a format called side-by-side, or SBS for short. You can think of it like this, two slightly different videos playing. Video A is for your left eye and video B is for your right eye. And then your brain merges them together and boom, depth appears. But hold on, you need a second thing to see 3D effect, and it's a compatible display. And without it, the magic falls apart. Without a proper 3D screen, both your eyes see both videos overlapped and it ends up looking blurry, like what you're seeing in the video right now. Because both of your eyes now see left and right video at the same time, so now you need a 3D display to separate each video to the correct eye. And that's where the Samsung Odyssey 3D steps in. It uses a special layer called lenticular lens. This layer splits the image so that your left eye only see left videos and your right eye only see right video. And when combined, voila! Your brains now get tricked into seeing the third dimension. It's kinda similar to the old school red cyan 3D glasses. The concept is basically the same. Two slightly offset images, one red and one cyan. The red lens blocks red light and the cyan lens blocks cyan light. And then each eye will get a different image. Your brains then put them together into 3D. And on the other hand, when you look at a picture, both of your eyes see the exact same thing. So your brains know that this is 2D. Now, for the experience with using the Samsung Odyssey 3D on a daily basis, it can be totally used as a regular monitor. The panel quality is great, with over 500 nits of brightness and 100% of sRGB, as well as 95% of DCI-P3 in color coverage. But of course, the real star here is 3D capability. For example, here I'm playing the game Kazan, and the 3D popping effect feels completely different. It's out of this world in the best way. There's depth to the surrounding, and some objects literally feel like they are popping out of the screen. The roads feel deeper, and sometimes I find myself leaning in to see what's around the corner. Way more immersive. Now, Kazan is a third-person game, but I believe in the future, when more first-person games support this kind of 3D effect, it will be even more realistic. That said, there are some limitations. As I mentioned earlier, the 3D effect requires super high precision, and this display aren't always perfect. They can't guarantee to replicate real-life depth 100% of the time, especially for those first-time users, you might feel a bit dizzy or even slightly nauseous. Plus, only a few titles support 3D for now. And to even test this game, we have to use a special beta version from Samsung. As for movie, I watched Spider-Man, and it was amazing. The depth is super clear, and you can feel the spatial easily. This screen also comes with a head tracking camera that follows your head position. It takes a few seconds to lock on, but when it does, you just need to stay around 80 cm away and avoid moving too rapidly, then it works quite well. However, I think that because of that added lenticular lens on top, the screen has a slightly grid effect, it looks a bit pixelated. So yeah, 3D movies aren't as sharp as 2D, but the spatial effect makes up for it. Also, beside the side-by-side 3D media, this screen uses AI to convert 2D to 3D, and yes, it does create artificial depth, but only about 70% as good as native 3D content that was properly tuned from the beginning. So to wrap it all up, our experiences with the Samsung Odyssey 3D was super exciting, but in my opinion, you shouldn't buy it just yet. The 3D display simply not ready, and it's kinda be a bit gimmicky. To get the 3D effect, you have to sacrifice sharpness, and for everyday use, the screen look kinda grainy. On top of that, there are just not much content that support 3D for now. Personally, I think that we're still in the early stages for 3D technology, but the potential is huge. And still, if you are a tech enthusiast who want to be an early adopter, this could be a cool toy to try. But how about you? What do you think about this Samsung Odyssey 3D? Is it cool? Let me know in the comment section, okay? And don't forget to hit the subscribe button so you won't miss any upcoming videos. Now, thanks for watching, I'm NK, and see you guys next time.